What's going on, YouTube? Nicholas here with Tech Love TV, where we don't discriminate and we believe all tech deserves some love.
I want to see some love. It's love day. I'm showing people love out here on the court.
Okay, so today, from the thumbnail, as you can tell, I do have a tech bag for you. Okay, so a quick disclaimer before I get into this bag. Voltaic did send me this bag for review on my channel, but I'm going to give you my unbiased and honest opinion as I do on all products that I review on this channel. And also, links will be in the description down below. And if you click on those links and you happen to buy something, I do get a small compensation from that as well. It helps support the channel. So now we got all the legal stuff out the way. Let's get back into this bag. Let me give you a little bit of a backstory. So I got a notification from Amazon because I was looking at tech bags. You know how they send you emails when you've been looking at stuff and you have something in your cart. They'll send you an email, let you know that, hey, this item is still available. Go ahead and check it out, whatever. So I clicked on that email, saw the bag that they recommended for me, and I was like, I don't like that one. But then as I was looking at that tech bag, this company called Voltaic, their tech bag showed up as well. And I clicked on it and I was looking at it, I was like, I like this. This bag is very nice. And so before I decided to click on it and make the purchase, I said, you know what? Let me reach out to them via email and see if I can get this bag to review on this channel. So I sent them an email. I didn't think they were gonna answer me back because I'm a smaller YouTube channel, so they just give me the cold shoulder for the time being. But the next day, they actually sent me an email back and said, hey, we would love for you to review our tech bag on your tech channel. It took maybe about a week before the bag was at my front door. And so without further ado, here it is. This is the Voltaic Array Solar Backpack. Let me go ahead and show you their website, because there are currently four different type of bags that they sell on their website. Okay, so here we go right here. Here is their website. And as you can tell, they do have solar bags on here, external batteries, solar panels, and a bunch of other stuff that you can purchase from them as well. But going into the solar backpack and bags category, here are the four bags that they currently sell on the website. You have the Converter Solo Backpack for $130. You have the Off-Grid Solar Backpack. You have the Solar Array Backpack. And you have the Generator Solar Laptop Charger. Now the Off-Grid and the Array Solar Bag, they're exactly the same. The only difference is the external battery that comes inside of these bags, and the Converter Backpack is obviously a little bit smaller. But if you are in the market for a new tech bag and you don't want to shell out $300 for a tech bag, and $200 is within your price range, I will go ahead and recommend the Off-Grid Solar Backpack simply because it does have a smaller external battery. It's about 12,800 milliamp hour battery, as opposed to the 24,000 milliamp hour battery that the Array Solar Backpack has. But either way, they're both exactly the same, and you will not be going wrong if you choose the Off-Grid Solar Backpack as opposed to this Array Solar Backpack. But before we get into all that, if this is your first time here, go ahead and smash that subscribe button right now. And don't forget, hit that bell icon so you get notifications on when I drop my latest tech video. So going around this bag, as you can see on the front side, it does have a very large solar panel. Okay, so this solar panel is 9 watts at 18 volts, water and UV resistant ETFE panel. Now I know you're thinking, what is ETFE? So, hey Google, what is ETFE panel?
On the website thoughtco.com, they say ETFE is an abbreviation for ethylene tetrafluoroethylene, a translucent polymer sheeting that is used instead of glass and hard plastic in some modern buildings.
Thank you. There you go. And then also it says monocrystalline. Now once again, I gotta defer to Google to let you know what monocrystalline is. Hey Google, what is monocrystalline?
Here's a summary from Wikipedia. Monocrystalline silicon, more often called single crystal silicon, in short mono-CC or mono-C, is the base material for silicon-based discrete components and integrated circuits used in virtually all modern electronic equipment.
And that's what it is. Okay, so that was the solar panel part. Now on top, you do have a harder shell pocket where you can hold sunglasses, anything in here that you don't want to get broken. On the left side of the bag, it has a pocket for, let's just say, a water bottle, or if you are a photographer, maybe travel tripod. On the backside, you do have cushion, and it also has voltaic symbol that pops out. Now, when I first started wearing this backpack, it took me a little bit to get comfortable with this poking in my back. I know it's on here, and you have the ridges on the side to create airflow so that your back doesn't get all hot and sweaty, but I did have to get used to this design being on my back. Also, on the back side of this bag, you do have a bigger pocket, and it unzips like this. It shows on the website that it is for a 15-inch laptop, but I can assure you this is a 15-inch laptop right here, and it will hold a 16-inch laptop if that is something that you're into. And as you can see, it is also accented on the inside with red. And also, there is a smaller pocket as well that holds a tablet. So if you have a laptop and a tablet, you have no problems fitting these on your back. And the total weight of this bag with the external battery and all before you start packing it is about 5.5 pounds, and the inside of this bag can hold about 20 liters. And the size of this bag is about 19 inches high, 11 inches wide, and 7 inches deep, which I'll get into more of that in a little bit. Now, on the right side of the bag, you do have two different pockets. You have a smaller pocket right here with a mesh pocket on the inside of that, and this is where I will put my cell phone, because it does have nice cable management holes that run throughout this bag that go all the way back to the external battery. So I will put my cell phone in here if I want to charge my cell phone on the go. And then the pocket behind this one is where you have your external battery. Now, since this is the Array Solar backpack, this is the 24,000 milliamp hour backpack, and it is held in by a strap because this thing is a beast. And then also, this cable that's already hooked up to this is the cable that's running to the solar panel on the front side. So let me go ahead and remove that real quick. Now, behind the battery, you do have another mesh pocket, and you have this key ring right here, so use it however you want to. There's two zippers for the main pocket, and they do zip all the way down to the bottom of the bag, and it is held together with these flaps. Now, these flaps are Velcro, and it opens fully like this. Now, on the inside, this does not come with the bag, but this is a camera bag that fits nicely inside. So for all you photographers, anybody that wants to travel with a camera, this camera bag fits nicely in here. This is the inside of the camera bag, so you will have your DSLR camera sitting right here, and then you also have a lot of inserts, and these are adjustable inserts so that you can put different batteries, different cables, whatever memory cards that you can put inside of here, and so that you can have everything all inside of this bag at once. On the inside of this main pocket at the top, you do have a mesh pocket with a zipper, and then there's two other mesh pockets down below. Now, this cable right here, this runs from the solar panel, routed all the way back through the battery on the right side of the bag. And then you also have another cable management hole right here, so it routes the cable from the external battery pocket to the back of the bag so that you can charge anything that you have stored in the back of the bag. And also underneath the bag, you do have straps right here so you can adjust the tension on the bag to your desire. The straps is one thing that I do believe that Voltaic can improve on. They are a nice shape. I do like the way they contour to your shoulders, but the only thing that I would like to have seen different, or maybe in the next version, is add a little bit more padding. There's a little bit of padding in here, but I've seen other tech bags with a lot more padding, and it just makes it more comfortable to wear. And you also have these stabilization straps, which is a nice touch for a bag that can be loaded down with a bunch of gear. Now, a few things that I forgot to mention at the beginning of the video, it does come with a few different cables. You do have your 20 volt AC cable, which is used to charge the external battery if you don't want to depend on the solar panel to charge your external battery. You also have a car socket adapter. You have a DC out cable. This DC out cable plugs into these laptop adapters. There's 10 laptop adapters here, and yes, these laptop adapters do come with this bag as well. And also, you have a bunch of different cables available on the website, and Voltaic was kind enough to send me this MagSafe adapter. I don't use a laptop that has this, but shout out to MagSafe for putting in the effort and sending me this MagSafe adapter as well. Okay, so now for this external battery. On the top, you do have your input 18 volt to 25 volt port. You have a USB quick charge. You have a USB type C port, and you also have an output 12 volt to 24 volt. Now, if you push this power button right here, it shows the screen. Now, this battery has the ability to change the voltage. So if you hold it down, it will cycle from 12 to 16 to 19 and to 24 volt. Depending on what you want to charge, maybe you have a laptop, your laptop, you can put it on 24 volt, or your cell phone or a tablet. You can change the voltage that you want the power coming out of here so that you can have the right amount of power to charge any mobile device that you're traveling with. Okay, so I do have some more specs for you. Okay, so for this V88 battery right here, it will charge your smartphone up about 7 times, DSLR cameras about 5 times, tablets around 3.5 times, and your laptop, you'll get around 1 charge, maybe a little bit more for that. And then for the solar panel, it will take this solar panel 14 hours to charge up this battery, 2 hours to charge up a smartphone, 2.8 hours to charge up a DSLR camera, 3.5 hours to charge up a tablet, and 12 hours to charge up a laptop. So I don't know if you have the time to wait, but I guess if you're in a pinch, you can use the solar panel up here if this battery is completely dead. But if you do have the option, I would definitely go and have this battery charge up my external devices instead of using this. But if you have to use this, you have it. Voltaic, this is a very nice bag. I do recommend this to anybody. And if you do have the additional funds to get the $300 bag, simply because you do have the bigger external battery. I think Voltaic makes very, very nice bags. I've been using this bag for about maybe 2 weeks now, and I have no complaints. And that's it, man. As always, if this is your first time here, this is the time. Smash that subscribe button. Hit that bell icon so you get notifications on when I drop my latest tech videos. And thank you for stopping by the Tech Love channel. My name is Nicholas, and I'm out. Peace.